Black Ops 4, my boy! Zombies! Black Ops 4 Zombies! Oh my god! I haven't said a word about anything yet. So, Black Ops 4 Zombies, has some hype going around it. There's, been a revealed poster, or not poster, what do you call it, what do you call that? A leaked image by Treyarch that says, Mankind Reckoning will be its salvation. Something like that. I'm pretty sure something along those lines. I don't remember exactly what the picture says. Might have it on screen. Not too sure. But anyways, Treyarch is freaking chewing the hype train right now. It's getting freaking insane. Now, Treyarch does this every freaking year with all their Call of Duties, of course. You know, they'd like to build hype around the game. And last time they did this, they had the zombie with the beast logo. Like the beast symbol for like the Apothecan beast symbol. It's like, oh, I'm freaking going beast. And it was pretty much the art they had for the steelbook, which had nothing really to do with the game at all in the end. Like in the storyline in the end, it had nothing to do with it at all mainly. And the poster itself, it was saying like, oh, the curse survived, whatever. Yeah, the curse, only the curse survived. Yeah, that's cool, whatever. But freaking, they did nothing with that. Like the only thing that kind of alludes to it in Black Ops 3 was like, oh, yeah, the curse survived. So let me just take the blood of the cursed, and then I'm just gonna, like, keep living. And you guys can live too if you want, and that's cool. That's pretty much how it worked. Well, Black Ops 4, Mankind's Reckoning will build salvation. That's, I'm pretty sure that's probably, some sort of biblical verse if I had to take a wild, goose guess. Yes, right there. And who knows? That could be the Steelbook art cover for the back of the Steelbook for Black Ops 4. Who the frick knows? Definitely, I don't know. I don't even know what I'm talking about. I'm just spilling random words. So what can we gather from this whole thing? So I'm gonna tell you right now, I'm not gonna break this thing down. I'm not Mr. Rough Waffles. I ain't gonna break this freaking thing down. That's not what I do. That's not my job. No. I'm gonna look at this poster and be like, oh, okay, there's a freaking dude that looks like he's kind of zombified with a freaking mask over his face. And then we got these other written languages that I guess is supposed to be, what's the word? Alchemical, whatever that's supposed to be. Alchemical antithesis, the gobblegum, I don't know. Something like that. It's supposed to be something crazy. It definitely means something, but what I gather from this is that it's a freaking dude from probably the 1200s, the age time, who has some freaking disease that makes him start peeling, and he has a mask to cover that. That's pretty much what I got from that, and it's pretty much like, hey, you remember freaking Revelations? Yeah, me too. That's pretty much what that poster says, or that little freaking image that they sent out. Now, don't get me wrong, every year when Treyarch does this stuff, it's always freaking the hype train, the choo-choo, you know, that thing is going at high blast, you know, like, there's some kid in the front of, like, the conductor's area, and he's just holding down the horn the entire time, because that's the freaking hype right there. That horn is the hype level, and the community is getting hyped about it already. Like, when people can make videos, when people can make 7 videos that are 10 minutes long about one freaking picture, that shows how hype people can get about the game, and how much they can leech off of it in a way. But that's kind of a good thing. In a way, it's a good thing. Build hype always helps. All hype is good hype, you know? Now, don't get me wrong. Alright, every time, you know, I see these videos, it's kind of annoying. But, like I said, don't get me wrong, it's not a terrible thing. It's just annoying to see in my sub box, like, oh, hey! This guy in the poster is, he's the guy from, the 18,000s. And he has, like, this one disease that makes him, like, zombie. Like, freaking people will talk about one thing that they find out about this picture, right? And then go on about it for freaking 10 minutes. It's insane how people can really do that. I wish I could do that. I'm just kind of babbling about me complaining about this. It's kind of dumb. But let me just talk about this. This video right now is most likely, to my knowledge, because I'm the freaking editor and the content creator here, probably gonna come out on the Wednesday before the reveal. And if you don't know, the community reveal for Black Ops 4 is happening May 17th. And today, as of recording, is May 15th. So tomorrow, this video will be going up, so you guys would be wondering, hey, this is a video. So be ready for that. But the hype train has definitely begun a very long time ago. I mean, by a very long time ago, I mean when that freaking picture came out. I actually don't know what I'm talking about anymore. I think I'm actually losing brain cells the more I keep having to stop to take breath. It's kind of crazy, but you know, I have to take a lot of breath because I talk a lot. Give me a lot of cutting in this video because how much I have to freaking breathe, but I just talk a lot because I'm a freaking idiot, you know? But that's all right because I have a lot to say, and sometimes I just have a lot to say, but then I'm like, oh, I have a lot to say, and then I don't say anything, you know what I mean? But they're also releasing, like Treyarch, they're also releasing, like, they have already released a bunch of other videos, like little GIFs of like, oh, there's a freaking, it's like pixelated gun shooting, you know, it's like freaking Minecraft survival game, pretty much, that's what I got from it. Pretty much what they're saying, what I can gather from all the teaser images or videos that they put on all the freaking different, Call of Duty accounts. From what I gather from all that, they are pretty much saying like, hey, we're pretty much gonna put, you know, survival games for Minecraft, we're putting that in the next game. That's what I got from that, because, you know, the pixels, the guns reloading, the bullet falling through the ground, Minecraft survival games. That's all I heard from that. That's the only thing I could really gather from those videos. I don't know how people got, oh, there's a zombie if you turn the screen about 90,000 degrees to the left. It's like, how do you freaking get, sure! Alright. Yeah, that's a thing that looks kind of like a zombie. Is it a zombie? Probably not. Could it be? It's at the 50-50 shot, you know? Either is or isn't. It could be a zombie? Or it could be some guy like, oh, hey, if you draw like a little outline around these things that look like eyes, that's a zombie. That's pretty much how it works. People with their theories are off the chain, as you could say. Very interesting people. You gotta love the Call of Duty community. I love it a whole lot, you know? It's funny. Zombie communities. I mean, not the Call of Duty community itself is, yeah, but the zombie community is yeet. You know what I mean? If I had to describe those levels of coolness in a way. This is a very weird video. I honestly do not know what I'm doing anymore with my life. All I'm doing right now is just sitting in front of a freaking microphone. And I'm freaking busting a sweat over here, you know? I just had a freaking, A tiny sweat droplet just rolled down my stomach. I'm freaking hot. I don't know what I'm doing with my life anymore. I'm just sitting here looking at a screen, looking at a microphone, looking at a gold PS4 controller, looking at a package of string cheese. Looking at a package of string cheese in front of me, a single sock. Note how it doesn't have another sock with it. Just a singular sock. Another blue PS4 controller. A red Mario controller for my Switch. The Switch itself. A box. A gold PS4. My laptop with a freaking sticky note on the camera. Freaking men's degree deodorant. This is my life! Alright, I need to calm down. I don't know what I'm doing. I might cut that entire part out. I might leave in it. I don't know. I don't really know. But let me just say this. Alright. Black Ops 4... I really do hope, I talk about this a lot in my Black Ops 4 videos, I really do hope that Black Ops 4 re-sparks the fuse that my heart has needed for a very long time, since the end of the Black Ops 3 days, pretty much, which is kind of last year, but not, you know what I mean. I really want that spark to come back, because back in 2015, when Black Ops 3 came out, that was the most hyped time of my entire freaking life. So much cool stuff happened in that short time. That made me really enjoy it. I was playing with my boy Mayhem. We played Black Ops 3 beta. That was the best time ever. Man, I wish I could go back. Those days were so fun. Then when the game came out, we played so much. And then I played zombies so much. I got so much better at zombies. Like before Black Ops 3, like Black Ops 2 Zombies, I was like, all right. It wasn't great, but I was okay. And now after Black Ops 3, I'm pretty much god tier. If you put me against frickin', Noah J? Noah J would get stomped. Just saying. I'm pretty good at zombies from Black Ops 3 because of Black Ops 3. And I just... The whole experience of Black Ops 3 was just such a fun ride through the whole thing. I don't know why. I enjoyed the multiplayer. I enjoyed the zombies. I played two missions of the campaign. Didn't play anymore. The campaign was cool. I've never been a campaign guy. It's never been my thing. Tried it. So with Black Ops 4, I'm really hoping that it re-sparks the fuse for me. It does cool stuff with zombies. I just want to see some simple stuff added to zombies, like picking your own characters, seeing different characters, having cool maps, having cool settings for maps, like the 1100s era would be really cool, you know, like, or like the time after the battle, like the great battle in the zombie storyline. That'd be cool. I would like to see stuff like that. Just small little things I'd like to see. I don't want to really see remade maps. If Mob of the Dead comes back, whatever, but I'm looking for more unique stuff than zombies that I've wanted for a while. Just little small stuff. That's all I want. I want weapon kits to come back. Those were cool. I just want little small things to happen that make me enjoy it. I want the same feeling with Black Ops 3, but 10 times better. 4 times better, you could say. 4 times. Because with Black Ops 3, Black Ops 3 was such a perfect game when it came out. Like, not many glitches. Some weapons were pretty overpowered. VMP. Looking at you. Looking at you, VMP. You're a freaking trash. I just want simple stuff to come back. All these cool things that were in the game in Black Ops 3, all there at the beginning. Paint jobs, all that stuff were so cool. I want some more cool stuff now. Like, if we can customize a character in multiplayer or in zombies, you know, put like a little patch on the shoulder or something like that. You know, something neat. That'd be cool. I'm just looking for the small stuff, you know. Little things that let me enjoy it. Maybe unlockable skins for characters. Like, let's say you complete an Easter egg as Richtofen, right? Let's say you should complete any Easter egg in a certain map, let's say. You unlock the Ultimus crew skin. It does not affect the gameplay at all. You're just a different skin. I would like that. Or just little things like that would make the game so much better for me. And more, make me enjoy it way more. Also, same thing with weapon skins. If they could take a World War II route with the weapon skins to make the guns look way different, I would like that. I really do enjoy weapon skins. It always adds like a little spice and flavor to the game. Like with Black Ops 3, the weapon variant, like the attachment variants were really cool. I really actually did like those. But they didn't change the weapon a whole lot. I was hoping that, like, let's say you had like an entire set of different variant attachments, it would change the entire base gun entirely, make it look how it should look. But, you know, it didn't do that. That's what I'm hoping for. And it didn't happen, but like, I'm hoping in Black Ops 4, they add weapon skins like that. That'd be cool to see weapon skins and zombies. I just like different things I can look at in game. Different little small things like that make me enjoy the game 10 times more. Like, let's say there's like a tiny DLC pack for like $1, right? You can pay for different looking perk icons, like the bottom left. So like, instead of them being like, let's say Jug is like red and white, they're just like red and black. Simple color change. I like small things like that. Small things like that is cool. Or like a weird neon looking color for those. That'd be sick. I just want little small things like that that will make me enjoy the game. Multiplayer, make it good. I like when multiplayers are good. Black Ops 3, I really, really, really like Black Ops 3 multiplayer. I will be 100% honest. I really did like it. Black Ops 2 multiplayer is pretty much on par with Black Ops 3 multiplayer for me. I still like Black Ops 2 as a game entirely more than Black Ops 3. But Black Ops 3 multiplayer is really good. I hope Black Ops 4 multiplayer, I don't want it to be boost jumping. But if it is, I won't be complaining. I just want a good in-between, because I don't want to be moving slow the entire time. I want to have momentum while also not being flying in the air, like, above your enemy. I want cool stuff like this, you know what I mean? I want fast movement that is fun, but not too fast, you know what I mean? Good stuff. Not World War II zombies. That's what I'm trying, or World War II in general. But, I think I've said everything I need to about this video. This video is probably going to be very long. I've had a lot of strange moments in this video. I'm probably going to keep everything in except for all my freaking breath I take. I've taken some breath in between my talking, so that's going to be kind of hard to deal with, but maybe I'll just leave it in there, whatever. I think I've said everything I had to say. So I'm gonna end off this video, just like I always do with all my videos, with a good old-fashioned, you know. Thank you guys for watching this video, and if you guys did enjoy this video in any way, shape, or form, then why not subscribe if you're new here, for you can see more amazing content from me. Anyway, I'm going to go, guys, if you guys have a wonderful day, and I will see you guys next time with another fantastic and amazing video. So peace out, guys, and I will see you next time, and like always, you gotta hit it with the good old cue! The outro!